This week on The Muse, are you hoping to buy your first home but could use some assistance for a down payment? The City of Perris can help with our first-time homebuyer program. Plus, Karina Espinoza has a great feature story on Hispanic Heritage Month, and we can't wait to share all the details with you. And the district elections discovery process is coming to an end, and it's time for the council to make a decision. It's all ahead on the Weekly Muse, and it starts right now. Hello, City of Perris. I'm Stephen Hale from the Clarence Muse Center in Perris, California, and welcome to The Muse. Have you ever wanted to purchase a home but can't seem to get enough for that down payment? Well, the City of Perris is here to help. That's right, the Perris Housing Authority's first-time home buyer program is now available. The first-time home buyer program provides qualified families with up to $50,000 in down payment assistance to help secure financing for the purchase of an existing or newly constructed home. Eligibility criteria includes that the property must be in the Perris Incorporated city limits, the borrower must be a first-time home buyer or any person who has not owned a home in the last 3 years, a minimum of 1% down payment of the purchase price, and cannot exceed 80% of the home income limits for Riverside County. If approved, the borrower is required to attend a HUD-approved 8-hour home buyer education class as well. For program detail information, please contact the Housing Department at 951-435-7216 or visit cityofperris.org/housingprograms. So go ahead and make that dream of becoming a homeowner a reality and submit your application to the first-time home buyer program today. And September 15th marked the beginning of Hispanic Heritage Month, where we celebrate the histories, cultures, and contributions of American citizens whose ancestors came from Spain, Mexico, the Caribbean, and Central and South America. For a more localized look at this month, here's Karina Espinoza.
There isn't an industry where Hispanic Americans haven't made their mark in history. Some of the most iconic politicians, activists, and entertainers in the United States are of Hispanic descent. Born in Arizona to a Mexican-American family, Cesar Chavez grew up around the people he later helped through his activism. However, the defining moment in Chavez's life came when his family moved to California during the Great Depression to become farm workers, cementing his fight for farmers' rights. A Bronx native of Puerto Rican descent, Sonia Sotomayor became the first Hispanic American to serve as a member of the Supreme Court. Sotomayor was nominated to the U.S. District Court of the Southern District of New York by President George H.W. Bush in 1991, and to the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit by President Bill Clinton in 1997. 12 years later, the Princeton and Yale alumni made history when President Barack Obama picked her as his first nominee to the U.S. Supreme Court in 2009. Senator Alex Padilla is the proud son of Mexican immigrants. His father is a short order cook and his mother a housekeeper. After graduating in MIT, Padilla was elected to the Los Angeles City Council, where he served as the youngest council president in Los Angeles history. He was elected to the state senate in 2006 to represent the more than 1.1 million people in the San Fernando Valley. Padilla also served as California's first Latino Secretary of State starting on January 5, 2015, and was reelected in 2018, receiving the most votes of any Latino elected official in the United States. Observing Hispanic Heritage Month allows our country to show its recognition and support for the work Latinos are doing in helping this country grow.
Thanks, Karina. The City of Perris has wrapped up its community engagement effort on the topic of district elections with their final survey. After the August 24th virtual meeting and the September 7th in-person meeting, the final step was a community outreach survey on district elections. And now the discussion pivots to the Perris City Council on September 28th, 2021. Coming up this Tuesday, the City Council will look at the data and findings throughout the engagement process and will determine if the city will move toward district elections. If the council decides to move forward, discussion will begin on what steps are next for the city to make this move, as well as determining a timeline for the move for future election cycles. Residents are encouraged to participate in the city council meeting and can make public comment at the meeting in support or in opposition of the potential change. If you'd like to watch playback of the virtual meetings or in-person meetings, review frequently asked questions, or to learn more about the timelines, the overall process, or map drawing, visit cityofperris.org/districtelections. And now for a look at your five-day forecast, here's Karina Espinoza with the weather.
Thanks, Stephen. The heat has returned but will cool off a bit as the week goes by. The wind will continue to blow mostly out of the west. We will experience roughly 50% humidity and some cloud cover over the next few days. So keep an eye out for flash floods and the most recent updates from the National Weather Service to protect yourself and your loved ones. Stay safe, Perris. Back to you, Stephen.
Thanks, Karina. Definitely looking forward to some cooler temperatures. And before we leave you today, two quick announcements. First up, come see us this Friday at 5 p.m. on September 24th at Mercado Park for our end of summer splash. Bring out the family and enjoy some live music, delicious food, and raffles. Festivities will close with a showing of the film The Croods, A New Age at 7 p.m. And did we mention there will also be a balloon twister and a character artist and interactive jumpers, yard games, and some arts and craft for the kids? It's going to be a blast. The first 200 guests will receive a free small shaved ice from Moore's Shaved Ice, courtesy of Dr. David Hernandez. Please be aware, once the movie starts, everything else will shut down for cleanup, so please come early. And lastly today, we want to remind you to update those calendars and make sure you participate in the Cruise and Care event coming up on Saturday, October 2nd from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. There is still plenty of space for healthcare vendors or for car submissions. The Cruise and Care event is a new event that combines the annual health fair event and the annual Rods and Rails event. This free event will be a mixture of food, car shows, health vendors, and lots of prizes, as well as a live music performance by the Sangria Band, a high-energy nine-piece group that features exceptional male and female vocalists, accompanied by a three-piece horn section and a dynamic rhythm section. To enter the car show or to register as a vendor, you can do so by accessing the Civic Rec portal on the main page of the city's website. And that'll do it for your Weekly Muse. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at City of Perris. And subscribe to the Perris TV YouTube channel for around-the-clock continued coverage wherever you are from your tablet or smartphone device. From the Clarence Muse Center in Perris, California, I'm Stephen Hale, and that's the Muse.